I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. As we head towards kickoff, two quarterbacks will be on the field today trying to push their team to victory. It's Palmer's Cardinals going up against Newton's Panthers. With that, let's get up to Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Arizona Cardinals and the Carolina Panthers. Turns and hands to Stewart. And he's going to be stopped here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Here's Newton now on second down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Marcus Golden from that outside linebacker spot. He's able to get in there for a loss of 9. I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. Time running out here on the play clock. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long. Third and long. It's Newton. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
Here's Ellington. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Completes it over the middle to Floyd. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Now Floyd's a guy the Cardinals want to get back on track. He's been in a bit of a funk this year. And against Seattle, 5 catches for 65 yards. And that was tying a season high.
Not only do they want him back on track, they need him back on track. Remember, Jerron Brown got hurt against Seattle. Looks like he's gone for the season. So they need Michael Floyd to really step up and assume the role that they thought he would fill.
Here's Palmer to throw. Fitzgerald bringing it in over the middle. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs.
Well, there's the first time in this game that Carson Palmer finds Larry Fitzgerald. Likely won't be the last, but how about the way these two have helped each other's careers?
Yeah, they really have. It's hard to believe with Fitzgerald, but really both of these guys, how long they've been in the league now. But Fitzgerald, gosh, third overall pick back in 04.
Yeah, how about that? Remember, Carson Palmer, a former Heisman Trophy winner. Yeah. he's finally found a real home in Arizona. It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Now Palmer, and Fitzgerald has got it. Touchdown, Cardinals. Larry Fitzgerald from 17 yards out, and the Cardinals have taken the early lead. And they will line up now for the two-point try.
Get ready. Move 58.
Palmer looking to throw. And no, it falls incomplete. So the two-point conversion, no good.
Well, partner, since this new two-point rule came into play, offenses spend a lot more time working on it. That means the defenses are doing the exact same thing.
Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. It's a very short kick taken by an up man. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And the Panthers coming out now. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Now a play fake here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And what about this offense, Charles? Specifically, what about Jonathan Stewart?
He makes sure everything goes. Put the ball in his chest and watch him run. Can run with power inside, but has enough speed that when he gets outside, he can cause a lot of trouble.
And oh, he sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. 23 yards on the play.
Well, plenty of credit has to go to the guy carrying the ball. He broke the tackle and gained the yardage. But that doesn't necessarily mean that the defender's bad. They're not going to make 100% of the tackles all the time. Even the best in the game will miss one occasionally. The key is not to let it snowball and miss tackle after tackle. On that play, credit to the offense, but that doesn't make the defense bad.
And he's brought down after a good game. They'll get 23 yards there. And the Panthers are going to get a first down. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Now Stewart on first down. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he will take it across for Panthers touchdown. Jonathan Stewart, 22 yards. And his guys are an extra point away now from taking the lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And it's no, he missed it. And the game remains tied. Oh, boy. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. Now it's Ellington to return. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
we'll
see if they dial it up this drive. It's complete. It's Fitzgerald. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. It'll be a gain of 9, and that'll make it second and short. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Second down, Palmer. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open. So it was tuck it and run time, and he picks up a first down.
They stay on the ground. This time it's Johnson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, in that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Oh, barely. They snapped it at one. Now Palmer. He's got to hook up to Floyd. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
A first down carry here for Johnson. And he'll take this one down near the 15. Make it now three straight games for Johnson over 100 yards after his 113-yard performance in Week 7 and 146 rushing attempts. Workhorse.
And I think there are some people that might be concerned with that volume, because when you look at what David Johnson's doing, in fact, one of our colleagues said it feels like he gets the ball in every play with Arizona right now, whether it's in the run game or the pass game. But as a College Football Hall of Fame coach who gently used to say all the time, you know, the ball's really not that heavy. Keep giving it to him. I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Here's Johnson, and he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
Second down, here's Palmer. That's caught at the three. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Michael Floyd, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Cardinals are in for six. And they'll get set here looking for the 2-point conversion.
Let's go.
They'll try and throw for it. And they don't get it. They tried for the 2-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. And the kickoff sails out of bounds, and that's going to be a penalty.
You can see the looks on the faces of the rest of the team. You have one job to do. Just kick the ball and play.
Well, that's exactly right, Charles. The kicker, this is just inexcusable.
Absolutely inexcusable. Everyone out there slugging it out for the entire game. Execute your job.
Of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, and it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. They come out here in the eye. Third and long. Cam fighting. He lost the football. It's out. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them. They feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Michael Floyd with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. So they're going to go for two. They'll look to throw. And unable to connect. They don't get the two-point conversion here. So the defense gets the stop. I know it's situation to situation, but who has more pressure there, offense or defense, when they go for two?
I truly believe it's the defense has more pressure because the offense has an entire playbook wide open from the two-yard line. You can run it. You can throw it. So defensively, I think most teams are going to be aggressive and force the issue and try and bring pressure.
Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. He can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
The throw on second down is Newton. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives them a new set of downs. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. They'll get the receiver involved here. It's Brown. And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Well, now they'll try the end around. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So second and medium, second and five now. It's a five-receiver set. Three to the left, two to the right. To throw is Newton. And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. So here's the Cardinals offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys. But be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. Palmer gives to Johnson, and he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front, because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Now Palmer to throw on second down. He's got Floyd out left. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those old reliable plays, because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw there.
And those guys like it, right? They can get the ball with a full head of steam.
Especially against man coverage, because man coverage, they're typically running away from someone and not worried about traffic coming out on the other end.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Here we go. 1, 18.
On second down, Palmer. Fitzgerald bringing it in over the middle. And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. He got 29 yards that time. So another snag for Fitzgerald, who in 2015 became the youngest receiver, right? That's Brown. Oh, barely. They snapped it at 1. Now the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion.
And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it 3rd and goal. So 3rd and goal. The defense in the dime.
Can still bring pressure.
Palmer will throw. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target. And it's 4th and 4. No movement from the field goal unit. They've got 4 full yards to go here on 4th and goal to hit pay dirt, but they're going to go for it. 4th down, here's Palmer. And this is incomplete. He had 3 touchdowns already, but won't get a... Starting field position here. Now a play fake here on 1st down. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he is out of bounds right around the 20. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
It's complete right side to Benjamin. So a nice job to break the 1 tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
And we're back now in Charlotte. It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the fourth. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Stewart is the lone setback. They go play at, and a big loss here as he's taken down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the
But he held on to it for so long, didn't get rid of it, and then just gave up.
Yeah, the coverage was good downfield, no doubt. But if you're going to hold on to the ball that long and then just cradle it at the end, you're right, it felt like he gave up a little bit.
If you're going to do that, do it early. Get the play over with. Don't wait that long and then give up. Your guys expect you to try and make a play.
Finding time. Benjamin with it over the middle. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Call it an even 20 yards on the pickup. And they're going to have a third down.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
The first down line at the 34 here on third down.
20.
They fake the give. Newton. And he can't quite pick it. No interception so far. That probably should have been their first, but at least it's fourth down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Set, 80.
Desperation time. Newton under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Brandon Williams in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
Here we go.
And Palmer gives to Johnson. And some space here. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 17 that time. And that'll be good for an Arizona first down. And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. From the red zone now, here's Palmer on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10.
Get ready. Move.
Second and 10. It's Palmer again. Completes it over the middle to Floyd. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Michael Floyd from 19 yards away. And the Cardinals now adding on to their lead. And they will line up now for the two-point try.
Get ready.
Palmer looking to throw. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So they're able to throw it in for the two-point conversion. Sometimes that can be a risky play, but they got it.
Yeah, you always have to be careful here because if you do get it intercepted and it's returned by the defense, that's 2 points for them. But he identified an open target and put it right on him.
Play fake to Stewart. It's Newton. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Now a play fake here on first down. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Frosty Rucker in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. To throw on second down is Newton. Time for a break. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. We'll come back and see this one out after this. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Third and long, it's Newton. He's going to let it fly. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. A big play there for the Panthers. 41 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator is looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described.
Look. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. And Dixon taking it in. And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a two-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt with a two-score game, they're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And he'll take it out of the side of the end zone, and they'll get it at the 25. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. They were trying to get it there to Michael Floyd, and now it's second down.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field has popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
Palmer now. He's got Floyd out left. And he'll be out of bounds up near midfield at the 49.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Right now.
Palmer apparently wants to throw it. He's going to go for a big play, and that's caught inside the 30. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
Let's face it, when Carson Palmer finds Larry Fitzgerald early in the game and then continues to do so, we end up with games like we saw after the 2015 season in the playoffs against Green Bay, don't we?
Yeah, and a couple of veterans for sure in this league.
veterans who know how to play and still love competing and do it at the highest level.
Even makes me feel old, though, that Palmer born in 79, Fitzgerald 83, and those are veterans now in the NFL, right? Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Here we go.
Throwing again here, Palmer. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Larry Fitzgerald, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. And they'll get set here looking for the two-point conversion. They'll look to throw, and this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. And the kicker commits the kicker's cardinal sin. He kicks it out of bounds. Down, it's Newton. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Off to Stewart, and some room to maneuver, and he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks, and now they're in the hurry up. They go back to Stewart on first, and he's brought down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Stewart is the lone setback. And he'll get it up the middle. And he's brought down. And a nice carry there of 15 yards. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout. So as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Comes to Stewart. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock.
It appears that the pressure is affecting him today. Normally, he knows exactly when to get rid of the football. But today, because he's been hit a few times, he's getting rid of it a little bit too quickly.
And this will likely be the last play and wrap things up. They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. It's a 5 receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. And this is going to be caught. So it affects the final score, not the outcome, but it is a late touchdown here on the game's final play.
Well, the lost sleep that the defensive coordinator had all week preparing for this game, a good portion of it was trying to prepare for him because he's absolutely a phenomenal player.
And a lot of times around the goal line, they know it's going to him. It's just so hard to stop.
And that's where it really becomes difficult because you're exactly right. They know it's going to him, yet they still can't stop it. That tells you when you're a dominant player.
Newton now to throw, and it's incomplete. It was an exercise in futility anyway. It doesn't affect the final outcome, and this one's over. Well, an interesting finish to this one. They get in the end zone at the end of the game, Then they went for two. It wouldn't have mattered. The game was over, but they didn't get that two-point conversion.
I think trying to get the 2 points, that was for pride for them. But obviously the guys on the other side of the ball.